which is above is also that which is below. Hermes Trismegistus. Everything which has been created, the macroism as well as the microism, consequently the big and the small world, have been achieved by the effect of the elements. The whole universe is similar to a clockwork with all its wheels in mesh and interdependent from each other. Even the idea of the Godhead as the highest comprehensible entity may be divided in aspects to the elements. In the oldest Oriental scriptures, the elements are designated as tattvas. In our European literature, they are only considered on the ground of their good effects, and insofar as we are warned against their unfavorable influences, which means that certain actions can be undertaken under the influence of the tattvas, or else must be omitted. The accuracy of this fact is not to be doubted, but all that has been published up to this date points to the slight aspect of the effects of the elements only. In the oldest books of wisdom, the tarot has already been written something about this great mystery of the elements. For the first card of this work represents the magician, pointing to the knowledge and mastery of the elements. On this first card, the symbols are the sword, the rod, the goblet, and the coins. These are the four elements. This proves without any doubt that already in the mysteries of the Yore, for the first tarot card, that is mastery of the elements, having been chosen as the first act of initiation. In honor of this tradition, I shall give my principal attention to the elements, for as you will see, the key to the elements is the main point with the help of which all occurring problems may be solved. According to the Indian succession of the tattvas, it runs as follows. The Akasha, the principle of the ether or spirit. Tejas, principle of the fire element. Vaju, principle of the air element. Apas, principle of the water element. Prithvi, principle of the earth. In accordance with the Indian doctrine, it has been said that the four somehow grosser tattvas have been descended from the fifth tattva, the Akasha principle. Consequently, Akasha is the cause, ultimate, to be regarded as the fifth power, the so-called quintessence, principle of fire. As it has been said before, Akasha, or the etheric principle, is the cause and the origin of the elements. According to the Oriental scriptures, the first element born from the Akasha is believed to be Tejas, the principle of fire. This element, as well as all the others, manifest their influence, not only in our roughly material plane, but in everything created. The basic qualities of the fiery principle are heat and expansion. In the beginning of all the things created, must there have been fire and light. And in the Bible read, Fiat lux, let there be light. The origin of the light, of course, is to be sought in the fire. Each element, and therefore that of fire, has its two polarities, i.e. the active and passive one, which must mean positive and the negative roles. Plus will always signify the constructive, the positive, the creative, the expansive, the productive sources, whereas the negative stands for all that is destructive or dissecting. There are two basic qualities which must be clearly distinguished in each element. Religions have always imputed the good to be the active and the evil to the passive side. But fundamentally spoken, There are no such things as good or bad. In the universe, there is neither good nor evil, because everything has been created according to immutable rules, wherein the divine principle is reflected. And only by knowing these rules, we shall be able to come near to the divinity. As mentioned before, the fiery principle owns the expansion, which I shall call the electrical fluid for the sake of better comprehension. This definition does not just point to the roughly material electricity, in spite of its having a certain analogy to it. Everyone will realize at once, of course, that the quality of expansion is identical with extension. This elemental principle of fire is latent and active in all things created, as a matter of fact, in the whole universe, beginning from the tiniest grain of sand to the most sublime substance, visible or invisible. The principle of water. Water is derived from Akasha, the etheric principle. But in comparison with fire, it has quite contrasting qualities. These basic qualities are coldness and shrinkage. The point in question are also two poles, the active one being constructive, life-giving, nourishing and protective, whereas the negative pole is similar to the one of the fire. It is destructive, dissecting, fermenting and dividing. As this element owns the basic quality of shrinkage and contraction, it has produced the magnetic fluid. Fire as well as water are operating in all regions. According to the rules of creation, the fiery principle would not be able to exist all by itself if it did not conceal inside, as an opposite pole, the principle of water. These two elements, fire and water, are the basic elements with the help of which all has been created. In consequence of these facts, we have everywhere to reckon on two main elements. Moreover, with the electrical and magnetic fluids which represent the contrasting polarities. The principle of air. Another element derived from Akasha is that of air. Initiated people do not regard this principle as a real element, but they will grant it the role of a mediator between the fiery and the watery principle, so that the principle of air will, in a certain way, establish the neutral equilibrium, acting as a medium between the active and the passive activities of water and fire. Through the interaction of the active and passive elements of fire and water, the whole created life has become motion. In its mediumship, the principle of air has assumed the quality of warmth from the fire and that of humidity from the water. Without these two qualities, any life would be inconceivable. These two qualities will also grant two polarities to the airy principle, which means in the positive outcome, the life-giving polarity, and in the negative aspect, the destructive polarity. In addition to that, let me say that the mentioned elements are not to be regarded as ordinary fire, water, and air, which would solely represent the aspects of the material, grossly material plane. But in this case, these are universal qualities of all elements are concerned. The principle of earth. It has been said of the principle of air that it does not represent an element proper, and this affirmation goes for the principle of earth likewise. Now this means that out of the interaction of the three aforesaid elements, the earthly principle has been born as the last element, which by its specific quality, the solidification involves all the three elements. It is this quality in particular which has given a concrete shape to the three aforesaid elements. But at the same time, the action of the three elements has been limited with the result of space, measure, weight and time having been born. The reciprocal action of the three elements together with that of the earth, has become tetrapolar, so that the earthly principle may be labeled now a four-pole magnet. The fluid in the polarity of the earthy element is electromagnetic. All the life created can therefore be explained by the fact that all elements are active in the fourth, the earthly element. Through realization in this element came out the fiat, it shall be. Details concerning the specific influences of the elements in the various spheres and kingdoms, such as the kingdom of nature, of animals, and of human beings, will be found, and the effect of the elemental principles in the universe.